What's it mean to manage by metric today on the Landlord Coach Dailyish Show?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, ignition,
liftoff. Hey everybody, welcome to the Landlord Coach Dailyish Show. A show for not just rental property operators and real estate people, but people who are looking to be time wealthy and have more control and more white space on their calendar. It's really good to see you. My name is Mark Dolfini, your host and landlord coach. But again, we're going to be talking about today managing by metric. What does that even mean? Well, really, we're gonna get into that in just a second, just a hot minute. We're going to get into that, but really quick. If you would like to get a free copy of the Time Wealthy Investor 2.0 in your hot little hands and learn all about the VIP method, which is about building a business infrastructure for rental property businesses specifically. But if you're really interested in just learning about the VIP method in general, you can get a copy of the Time Wealthy Investor 2.0 for free. I just ask you to cover shipping, but you can go to landlordcoach.com/videos. But right now, what are we talking about today is what does it mean to manage by metric? It was interesting because I was talking to a couple different people over the last week, just reconnecting with some people that I haven't seen in a while. I was just sending messages and like, hey man, thinking of you, hope you're doing well. And I found a lot of fake profiles out there. I was actually kind of shocked. I was like, you know, I would reach out, because I reach out to everybody, anybody that is always messaging me. I'll always say, you know, I always make a point to reach out to individuals that are saying hello, reaching out and saying hello, right? And sorry, let me connect here. My internet seemed to be in and out. There we go. All right, now I'm connected. So it was interesting because I would always make a point to reach out to individuals and say, hey, how's it going? You know, nice to meet you. Have we met? You know, that sort of thing. Or at least, you know, I don't recognize your name or something. And they would never message back. So it was just one of those things that I'd end up going back to their profile. I'm like, oh, you've got like, you know, 5,000 friends and nothing mutual. Okay, you're obviously just a just a collector, and move them on, and right, that sort of thing. So I was reaching out to some people that I actually do know and would engage with them and have conversations with them back and forth. And it was interesting. There was just one guy I got talking to, that he heard me talking about managing by metric before, and he knows that I always am more interested in life output than in income generation. And not necessarily that I think life output is or income generation is meaningless, but quite the contrary. We all have goals and aspirations and things that we want more in our life. I don't think that that's wrong. As long as we're living our purpose and living our vision, I think that's entirely correct. But he was talking about, and I don't remember which book he was referencing, but how he has really been focused on making sure that he is home a certain number of days on time, because he would tell his wife, and my bride can 100% relate to this, so I feel like I'm confessing here, but one of the things that I would do is I'd say, hey, I'll be home at 6, and around 6:30 I come strolling on in thinking I'm doing great, right? Well, really, in reality, I'm just lying to myself. I'm being dishonest. You know, when it's 6 o'clock, I'm like, oh, okay, well, I should start packing up. No, my bride has an expectation that I'm home at 6 if I say I'm going to be home at 6. So as a result, you know, I'm just lying to the one woman I shouldn't be lying to, even though I don't really consider it lying. I'm just like, okay, well, maybe I'm just being overly optimistic, right? But in reality, it's not being honest, right? Well, he started tracking that in terms of when he was actually going to be home. And I'm thinking, oh man, that is a really, really good metric, right? In terms of managing by metric. So let's talk a little bit about managing by metric. And I had another conversation, I had several conversations this past week, which were fantastic, with people who were interested in some coaching sessions and people who just were just interested about, you know, just conversations in general, not necessarily coaching. But there's four basic functions to any business, right? So whether you're watching this and whether you're a real estate person or not, there's four basic functions to a business. And those four basic functions, you have to have each four of these functions. No matter how complex the business is, you still have to have these four basic functions. And that's your lead generation, right? You have to, the world has to know that you're in business, right? Secondly, there's the sales piece that's, okay, so the leads come in, those leads have to be closed. So the sale has to be closed, right? So you have your lead gen, your sales. Then the third piece is the operation. What's the business do, right? So what's the operational function of the business? And then, so you can call that fulfillment, you can call it whatever else it is. And then you have the accounting piece, right? So when you're managing by metric, you have all four of those basic functions. Now, he was managing by metric by saying, okay, sweetheart, I want to be home 80% of the time when I say I'm going to be home. That's what he's doing in his personal life, which I thought was brilliant, right? Because who was going to keep track of that? Of course his bride was. And they made it fun, right? Of course, it's like, hey, you're home at 6:01. So, of course, if he didn't hit the 80% mark in that month, now it's like, okay, well, he's got to do the dishes for several weeks or something, whatever it was. I don't remember what he said, but it was just kind of funny that they were having fun with this. But the interesting thing is when you're doing this with your business, that's when you can start really managing your business and managing by metrics. So that's what I was talking about. And those four areas, those four key areas that every business has to have. I don't care if you're a gym owner, if you are a fix and flipper, or if you're a realtor, whatever it is, whatever you do, if you're in real estate or razor blades, whatever it is, then you have to have those four key functions, right? So your lead gen, your sales, your operation, and then your accounting. So in terms of managing by metric, you can have metrics for everything. Like think about baseball. Baseball tracks literally everything, right? Hits, bunts, bats, they literally track everything. Well, if you guys think about it, you can still track anything in your business. Now you want to track stuff that's meaningful. You want to track stuff that's not going to relate to the operation of the business, but you can track all sorts of different things. For example, what could you track in your marketing piece? Well, if you're spending dollars, right, that are going out, you probably want to make sure that those dollars impact a certain number of leads, like you're getting so much for it. So it's ideal that you know in advance what you want to get from those marketing dollars. What's the action you want them to take? Is it them clicking on a website? Is it them scheduling a call? Is it, whatever it is. So based on the marketing dollars, so you can say, okay, well, based on the number of people that are coming to us, the number of leads that we got, it's, those 100 leads cost us $1,000. So, that you could, now you have a metric, right, that you can track. And now you can only try to improve on that metric over time. So that's how you could do that with the lead gen, just as an example. For the sales, how many at-bats does it take for you to close business? How many at-bats does it take for you to get a closed customer? How often are you tracking that? If you're not tracking that, right, you really have no idea how you're doing. And so what about the next piece? What about the production? What about the production of your business? How many widgets are you selling? How many, whatever the thing is, you can track your production for how many hours you're taking to close that particular sale or whatever it is. Whether you're a wholesaler, whether you're a fix and flipper, whether you're, again, whether you're a gym owner, right? You have the production, you have the fulfillment piece of your business. So you can figure out how many people are actually showing up and how effective, how impactful are you at delivering and fulfilling the product, right, or the service. And then finally, you have the accounting piece. And the accounting is all about metrics and functions and things like that. But unfortunately, lots of people aren't using that well because the accounting piece often isn't done very well. Or if it's done, the business owners don't really know what they're looking at. They don't really have an understanding of what a balance sheet is or an income statement. And that's not, you don't need to be a full-blown accountant, but you need to kind of understand what it is that you're looking at. And most businesses, which is interesting, because if you've not read one of the books that was a really, really good book that I would recommend for most business owners to read or at least be familiar with is Scaling Up 2.0. It's Mastering the Rockefeller Habits. And it was a book by Vern Harnish, which I got to actually meet Vern. Super freaking smart guy. Like this dude he's flipping smart. Like he's really, really smart, scary smart. But the interesting thing is that book reads like a textbook. So I would recommend it more on Audible, even though I'm not necessarily an Audible learner. I'm more of a visual kinesthetic learner, but the book was fantastic. But the interesting thing was most growth companies are not focused enough on their cash. So they're more focused on profits. And the interesting thing is it takes cash to grow a company. So if you're not focused on your cash, you can very easily grow broke. And that's kind of what happened to me back in 2008, 2009. I was growing so rapidly that I wasn't really paying attention to that stuff. So managing by metric. Well, the interesting thing is, and it was, I'm blanking on the name right now, but he's written like 7,500 different books, and I'll think of it here as soon as we end the video. But he said that if you can't measure it, you're not going to manage it. You have to be able to measure what it is that you want to manage. And if it's really interesting, because if you're not going to take the time to measure this stuff, then you certainly can't manage it very well. So it was when I was talking to my friend, and he mentioned that he's tracking the number of times that he's going to be home on time. I thought, man, what a really fun way to make sure that your life output is being generated by, you know, that you're doing the things that you want, that's in alignment with your vision. So let's look at it another fun way. Like, how many vacations are you taking per $30,000 of net income, right? For example, how many times are you spending with having an individual moment with one child? If you have two or three children, you know, they probably want you and more of you individually, not just family time, but how much time are you spending with your spouse? How much time are you spending with your oldest and your youngest? Or if you have a middle child or two, how much time are you spending individually with each one of them per month, right? And these are metrics that you could easily track. And here's the thing that, and I want to end this up, and I'm hopefully I'm not coming across preachy, because this is something I'm going to start to implement, because yes, those are things that are in my vision, but you know what? I recognized I'm not really tracking them that closely. Even though I want to have lunch with my gal every weekday, I don't really track it that often. But it's kind of one of those things that I notice that, hey, we're not jiving, we're out of sync. And you know what happens? You know why that is? Because we haven't been having lunch together. We get out of sync, and all of a sudden we start to bicker about dumb things. And I'm like, wait a minute, what's going on? Oh, we haven't spent good just time together. We just haven't been watering that grass. So it was really interesting. So I'm like, wow, what? Like, I should be tracking those metrics as well, because if I really want to be intentional about it, and I really want to have this life output, you know, this life defined by life output, not so much by income generation, why can't I track that as well? So I don't know. I challenge you all just to maybe start to think of different ways that you can track not just the metrics of those four key areas of your business, but also the measures of life output that really matter to you most. So that's all I have for today. No comments. You've got a quiet group today. So it's nice to see you all, and I appreciate you coming by. But if you are interested and you are seeing this on the Facebook, you can join the discussion at the Landlord VIP Lounge. Actually, I changed the name of that. It's actually the Time Wealthy VIP Lounge now, because it's I had so many people that were coming to the group that really aren't really all that interested in landlording, but they are either small business owners or they're side hustlers or whatever it is. So I got to change that. How about that? All right. Well, anyway, that is all I have. So again, you get what you pay for with this show, right? All right, that's all I have for today, everybody. Please be sure to place a value on your free time, because if you don't, someone else will. And most important, there is no amount of money that will make time irrelevant. Have an awesome day, guys. I'll see you next time.